Fuck it, we're doing it live. Very strange is coming, guys.
We'll embrace the revelations.
It's cooling.
With the ringing of the bells. Till every soul and every nation. Here's the truth these travelers will tell.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is DeadwingDork, and something very strange is coming very quickly our direction. I was considering doing this as a video. I'm still going to do this as a video, but I've decided why not share the pain with you fine folks live. So this stream is not going to be archived. You can find it probably on the stream's playlist, if I remember to put it there. Sometimes I don't. But it's not going to be on like a normal stream that you can traditionally see. This is gonna be like a secret stream, okay? This is just between you and me. You know what? This is a VIP stream. You guys right now, you are the most important people. All those other fakers, they couldn't make it. So we're gonna be looking at the carpet sample fursuit guy. Now, a lot of people got in touch with me when this tweet went around. I think somebody said, like, what's the greatest example of furry degeneracy that you've ever seen? And somebody responded to the tweet with this fine gentleman, who I suppose I'll show right now. You've seen him in the thumbnail, but get a good look at your boy. This is Carpet Samples. That's what people have taken to call him. He is a fursuit making individual, a furry, if you will, who has made this fursuit out of the plush dolls that he has reportedly bedded. I'm gonna use the term bedded. He has made his way with these plush toys, and then he's skinned their carcasses. Is it carcasses or like carcass eye? I'm not sure. But he's turned them into this sort of Buffalo Bill-esque fursuit abomination. And, yeah, I don't know. I just don't know. I thought that it was just the fursuit that was the problem, because people said that the fursuit like reeked of piss, and apparently he like never washed it, and of course he made love to the plushies that he used to make it, so you can imagine some of the other cornucopia of smells, potpourri, if you will, of smells. It's only smells. But I thought that it was only smells, and then it turned out that apparently he's also into, like, some snake thing stuff. Apparently your boy is in, like, his 50s, 60s at this point. I think he's in his 60s. And, yeah. Really into dog stuff. But we're gonna get into that. How is everybody doing right now? 60. Boomer fur, yes. That's not a furry, that's a cryptid. You're right. Also, my super chat thing is not working right now. That's a problem. Is there a way I can, like, refresh this? Hang on. Skip alert, mute event sounds. Pop out, maybe? No? Okay. Well, we'll just hope that it starts working. I don't know, but... that's a problem. Let's see. Just woke up. Gonna head back to bed. Thanks. I mean, that's probably a good way of doing things. He's a boo-woomer. Absolutely cursed. What do you mean? You mean this is cursed? You mean you don't like this? Yeah, so we're gonna be looking at this guy. There's gonna be some other stuff to take a look at here. I've been wanting to do kind of an assortment of trash for a little while. And I decided to just roll the carpet sample fellow into this assortment. Yeah, we're going to be looking... I think there's something to do with the female masking community. I'm not going to tell you any more than female masking community, but that's a thing. That's going to be pretty exciting. I have to check the YouTube thing now for super chats. Let's see here. We got $2 from Mew Ichigo. What in God's name are we going to look at today, boy? Well, I've already explained some of it. Some of it might just have to be a surprise. What else do I have here? What else do I have here? Why do I have Lunatic Larry bookmarked? Oh, because it's a crazy fucker. Okay, well, maybe that then. I don't know. There's a few things. There's one that's not even, like, crazy shit. It's just funny. If you've seen Leon Lush's recent video, you might have some idea of what it is. But yeah, we got a few things to look at today. $5 from Smegma on Demand. Oi, Goof Troop guy, I know you are here. What other streams do you watch besides Deadwing and Medicar? You seem to have good tastes. Well, if I'm allowed to comment on this subject, if I do say so myself, I'd go with Kit Boga if you want to see somebody wasting people's time in an effort to ruin criminals' lives. That's pretty cool. If you're into the gaming, I go with... Really, the only gaming stream I watch is Vinny and Joel. So I don't really watch that many streams, to be honest. $2 from Matt G. Papa Claw Heart. I love you as always. Thank you. I hope you enjoy the stream. $2 from Basan Kappa. We may all disagree on furries, but we must unite. Yeah, sometimes it's like when a kaiju attacks. You know, all of the countries need to just, like, stop fucking worrying about who's wearing what color turban and just start blasting at the big guy, you know? Not that this is a bully stream. We're not bullying anybody. Although, one of the problems with talking about the carpet sample guy is that much of the info about him is like gone now, because he's been on the, as he is such an old individual, he's been on the internet for quite some time. And, he's kind of deleted a lot of the stuff, but we're going to be able to look at some of it, and we're going to be able to read some testimonies from people that have encountered him, and maybe we'll uncover some stuff along the way. It'll be a merry, fun, perhaps even gay adventure. $2 from Azuri. What's good, Claw Papa? Well, probably not this stream, but you know what? We'll see. $2 from Harry Connor. This gives me depression. As it should. As it should. $2 from ZZZZZZ. That's not a furry. That's a cryptid. Yes, I think I read that, and you might be right. 40 rubles from Medicare's Lunicorn Archives. His fursuit makes him look like he's a zombie. Yes, he does look like some kind of abomination. This is another one of those people who's been on the internet for a while and as such has been memed for a while, because, I mean, just look at the fucker. Just gaze upon its visage and beware, despair. Let me see here. Ooh, jumping ahead here. $2 from Kate Rau Rau. What sort of FNAF OC monstrosity is this? I mean, this is the one to rule them all. This is like the double dodeca Vegeta version of Freddy Fuckbear. $2 from Joshua Young. Hirsute fursuits. Yes. $5 from Not Gone. New Donnie Darko. Looks good. You know, that would be the edgy reboot. $2 from Milady Class. Frederick Knudsen retweeted a tweet about this guy. Yeah, he actually had some info for me when I think I tweeted about it. I think I said I was going to make a video about it, and I still am, if you're just joining us. This one's going to be not archived, but I am going to edit. Probably going to have some fun things to edit out of this stream, so that's going to be good. I also, this morning, I started doing the Movie Bob Part 2 video. It's very exciting. But, yes, this one's not going to be archived, but when I did say that I was going to do a video about him, Frederick sent me the link to the... Sadly, Encyclopedia Dramatica is down. Ironically, for a site called ED, it's having trouble staying up, and it's been down for like a couple months now, and most of the info about this fellow, this carpet sample fellow, is on Encyclopedia Dramatica, so I had to go by an archive to get some of this stuff, so it's pretty incomplete. Such is the problem when, you know, a lot of this stuff is ancient. There's no Kiwi Farms thread about this guy yet. He's one of these people that's kind of skirted under the radar because, you know, he's been around for so long that most people just forgot about him. But, he's out there, and apparently he's accepting Craigslist, ads about dogs. He's responding to adopt a dog Craigslist ads, so that's a little bit disturbing. Let's see. $5 from Victor N. That Twilight plushie guy has a fursuit, not sure how long, and even lives in the same state as me. I remember seeing him at our local furry convention. Well, I will, I'll refrain from asking why you were at the local furry convention, sir, but, you know, I don't know, that's chilling information, you know? It's like being in the same time zone as Onision, I don't like it. $5 from A New Age. I'd rock and sock this furry's solar plexus with my airsoft pew-pew and strap him down like a Piggly Wiggly while my weird minion punches his head. That's the best thing I've ever read. Thank you very much. I'm not even that high right now, but, you know, you're making up for it. $2 from Basan Kappa. Everyone clench up for some prime kringe. Yes, this is going to be quite something. $5 from Meet the Galaxy. I love you, Kinga. About the Moona and the Juna and the Springa. $10 from Kate Rau Rau. Clawfather, are you a fan of really weird Kringa artists? I would highly recommend checking out Skunky Toontastic. She has a ship of Goku Black and Zamasu as Ice Age squirrels. Uh-huh. That's marvelous. Thank you. Thank you for the suggestion. I'll look into that. Skunky Toontastic. That one Google search. Thank you. $2 from Mew Ichigo. We're going to need Sangi, aren't we? Yeah, this is going to be a Sangi-tastic stream. This is going to be quite the Sangi stream. So, let's If you're, by the way, I'm having problems with the super chat thing in Streamlabs OBS, so that's a little bit annoying. But you know what? I think we'll manage to manage. Let me see here. What should we start with? Well, firstly, let's begin with... Now, one of the sites that still has pictures of his, and many of these were uploaded over 10 years ago. I think the newest one on there is from 2009. So that should give you some idea. But many of these were uploaded quite a long time ago. We can't exactly look at his Flickr, because there's some NSFW stuff on there, but with careful editing, which is to say cropping in MS Paint, I've weaned it down to a trilogy, if you will, of very important images. So here we have the need for a Sangi. Hang on, this goes above everything else. Thank you. And, yeah, you can see there's something quite a bit not okay happening here, in the top left. I don't like this. I don't like that. That one on the left, yeah. I think the Encyclopedia Dramatica lists this picture as... possible zoophile stuff happening right here. Thankfully, we can't see any specifics, so I'm going to say this is okay to show. I don't think it's anything. I think it might be an indication of something, potentially. But, you know, a naked man holding his dog with its legs spread. That's a little bit concerning. But yeah, quite a many pictures of this dog. Which is concerning. As we can see, there's a couple pictures of him, the man of the hour himself. I believe somebody in a post we will read shortly has described him as what did they say? A meth head Steve Buscemi. And they're not wrong, I must say. So there's that. There's that picture. That's some of his Flickr. Now again, a lot of stuff on here. There's not that many pictures, but. Number of them are too hot for YouTube, so really none of these should be on YouTube, but I mean, here's some of the fursuit stuff. You can see some of this weird patchwork fucking cotton candy abomination. We've got some kind of sex weirdo comic up here that looks like it was drawn in crayon. Wait, he was on Dr. Phil? Is that true? Is that true? Was this man on Dr. Phil? I would be interested to hear about that. Yes, he was. The dude with the long hair, yes. Boomer the dog? He's Boomer the dog. I don't think it said that on the Encyclopedia Dramatica. You guys might be mistaken, but we can look into that. That's very interesting. We'll definitely be looking into that. But yeah, here we've got a cute puppy, everybody. Look at the cute... Make sure that Sangi's visible. Look at the cute puppy, guys. Isn't that puppy so cute? Doesn't that puppy just make you feel all cute and... kawaii, nah? Don't you feel that? Yeah, as you can see, again, there's these fursuits. We got the... Oh, yeah, this picture here in the middle bottom, this bitch is for you, it's called. I had to crop it at exactly this point because below this you have some very crudely drawn. It's barely possible to even make it out, but there's some tit meat and some vajuju. So we had to crop it here. But yes, this is some kind of weird, I guess, illustration of this thing. I don't know. Wear waves for Jesus. I think a lot of Jesus is currently required in this situation. A lot of Jesus must be administered directly to the affected area. So that's the flicker. And finally, there's a couple of pictures that I had to crop out because they're a little too hot. They're from Second Life. And thankfully, this one here, despite the lewd connotations, is in fact okay to show. Because there's no funny business. There's just some sexy business, you know? We got breast sex female. We got another sex store. Oxima Route Moonshadow Ruby. That's one of the nicknames for this guy, is Moonshadow. He has a bunch of aliases, and this is but one of many. But yes, breast sex female, everybody. Remember Second Life? Remember Scarface? Yeah, I just thought that was worth sharing with y'all. But apparently that was some of his epic playthrough of Second Life. I'm sure he streamed it, and it was like a big-time Let's Play at the time. I'm sure everybody had fun. But yeah, we're going to be looking now at, let's see, what should we do first? Well, let's do a quick run-through of the Encyclopedia Dramatica page, because this has some good info. Some stuff I can't show. I might have to be a little careful here. But this is going to be interesting. I'm going to be reading Encyclopedia Dramatica on stream, everybody. By the way, I have stream Doritos. I brought the Dorit so that you guys can yeet. So don't mind the ASMR on occasion. Well, this... Oh, God. Okay, well, sadly, we're going to have to completely skip over the art section. Because this is quite a bit too hot for YouTube. There's a lot of... I want to say impressionist titties. This looks like there's fucking entrails. Oh, God. Okay, so, oh, God, this one's definitely bleeding. I don't like that. So we're gonna skip over the art section. So we're going to be a little bit careful. But we're going to go from the art section, and then we're going to go from above the art section and then jump down. That's how this is going to go. All right. We're not going to get effed in this stream. We're not going to get stream yeeted. Not by my watch. So, of course it didn't want to work this time. That's cool. So welcome to Encyclopedia Dramatica, everybody. This is the archive. This is basically, sadly, because this site is down, this is basically the only real repository of info on this guy. There's a couple other, like, there's a wiki fur page, but it's not particularly comprehensive. Let's see here. William Clark, also known as Shadow Wolfess, is a disgusting display of humanity that was sadly not aborted and was thus born on March 3rd, 1956. His fursona is a sickening anal beast that has dongs and tits, usually more tits than dongs. He draws horrible furry porn of characters with puckered assholes that are more often than not spewing shit. Shadow Wolf S is a wildly unpopular individual, even amongst furries. According to those people who have met him, he has a habit of vividly describing how he fucks dogs, loving to do so in paragraphs that have the spelling and capitalization that don't resemble any form of competent writing skills. Not surprisingly, he's also a pedophile and has even gone so far as to solicit a minor for sex in exchange for alcohol. He also enjoys having sex with stuffed animals. Although he openly gives out his phone number and his address, it is still uncertain how he gets electricity in a dumpster. Hang on. Where's our boy? There ya go, baby. Get that sangy front and center. Front and fucking center for this one, baby. Okay. How you doing, chat? Dog Onision? Sangy face, yeah. Burn in holy hellfire. This is most definitely another snake thing. The problem with this guy is...
Dorito break, sorry.
The problem with this guy is that if the stuff that people say about him is true, he is probably worse than Snake Thing. Because he's been allowed to operate for a long time, and apparently people aren't really that familiar with him. A lot of eyes fell on Snake Thing for obvious reasons. Obviously, Snake Thing was a pretty young individual at the time that it all happened. But this dude's in his 60s and has presumably been doing whatever he's doing for a long time. So again, not making any accusations here, but if what this page says at least is true, if a tenth of what this page says is true, is actually true, that's not good. That's not good. That is not good. So, we got a bunch of other aliases here. Oh god, hang on. Can I show this? Hang on. Okay, I can show this much. This is fine. Let me scroll exactly here. Okay. So, he's got a bunch of aliases here. Ron Mexico. I like that one. In his own words, his art. I am a 51-year-old furry hetero. Male bi for fursuits plushophile male. I fursuit yif and yif RP. As an emerald green with black socks and iridescent purple and dark green tail. Female wear fox vixen shadow wolfess. Yiffy art is my passion. And I do commissions cheap or free for comments. Pending one drawing of a real cute and yiffable female polar bear cub. Title is Iced Cub Means Child, by the way, everybody. Cub means it's not just a baby, but it's also an animal. So that makes it okay, apparently. Iced to yiff here would be heaven. Moonshadow Luna 49 is my artist sig name. Gmail me about commission prices and free samples. Draw any fursuit or fur full color artist pencil as I'm pretty good yiffy artist. Right. Another thing that we missed here briefly is unable to find a roommate. Wow, I wonder the fuck why. Bill passes out in a hotel lobby at a convention. Also, the swastika on his forehead hints at another possible turn-on of his. Uh-oh. Stinky. Sadly, we can't look at this picture in full, but I did hear from Fred how this guy has a history of, like, falling asleep either outside of hotels or, like, either outside of the hotels or in the lobbies because he wouldn't get a room. So yeah, that's him, I guess, asleep on a bench. That's cool. But yes, yeah, sadly, we can't take a look at the art here. You can see the thing here if you'd like to look it up. The URL, you can do that. We're going to skip on down for just a sec. Past the art, because it is a little bit too hot for YouTube. And thankfully, I think the rest of this page... Well, up to the fucking docs. I'll read parts of it. I won't read the juicy shack meat, but so can I show this last? No, I can't. Okay. Okay. Well, I will show this much, which is the tail end of, no pun intended, of the art section, where under one of these it says, "Yes, I was trying to show the bloody mess he caused to happen when he took her virginity." So that's pretty cool. You know, that's pretty artistic. Fursuits. After shopping all of his local thrift stores, repeatedly molesting everything that he purchased and then chopping it up, Bill enjoys making fursuits from the spare parts. All of his Ed Gein-inspired outfits are female, or Herm, of course, and he wears them proudly. "Well, I was lucky enough to have a mother intelligent enough to realize her sons needed to learn to sew, too. She taught me everything I know. Well, for the head, all you really need is a large high-heat hot glue gun. Just make a skeleton head, or as I call it, a prototype, out of plastic mesh. Really cheap at Walmart, around 35 cents a sheet. You just cut up pieces of fur to the right shape and glue them on in layers, building up the cheeks with couch foam." We got foam! "Foam from old couch cushions or cardboard, etc. There's lots of great videos on YouTube on fursuit making. It's very easy, as I'm seeing kids making, assume, werewolf heads that look surprisingly like..." Does he mean awesome? Did he just... Okay. "That look surprisingly like real fursuit heads for Halloween. With now, get this, a moving jaw. So cool. Even I haven't figured the trick to make that work right. Every time I kill him, the jaw stops moving all easy like..." Oh, wait. That's not there. Sorry. "Or, if you just need a partol suit head, paws, arms, legs, feet, and tail, maybe I can make time for you and build you one. It takes around 1 month for a good well-sewn partial, as I'm currently working on a pink dog suit for my roomie and buddy Boomer the Dog." Okay, Boomer the Dog is this guy's friend. I don't think this guy is Boomer, but apparently he's like friends with this dude who went on Dr. Phil, I guess. So that's interesting. Coomer the Dog. Yes, I know, chat. Boomer the Dog. Contain yourselves. Contain yourselves. I'm gonna boom! Anyone taking notes? No, just me. Hang on. Put user in timeout. There you go. Let's see. "So I only charge for the labor and the fur if I can even find what you want. It's better to send me the fur. Total cost $200 for a good partial. Most charge $300 for a head alone. The only most fursuit heads..." You know, I can't even say that most of them aren't horrific, disgusting abominations. So actually, no, never mind. You're right. That's fine. "The only restriction I have is I only do plastic eyes. I don't do the painted kind, because I can't paint worth a darn. Hope this helps." Shadow Wolf asks on why he's such a skilled and successful fursuit maker. Now, I wish we could find these quotes in the wild, but sadly, again, a lot of his stuff seems to have been scrubbed off of the internet. But thankfully, we can show some of these things. As thankful as we can be. We don't need to... Okay. All right. We're getting into some serious snake thing territory, ladies and gentlemen. Buckle up your fucking asses. But what do we have for these fursuits here before we get into the actual real-life dog fucking? He's most likely dead. I mean, potentially. He's pretty old. I don't know if anybody's actually heard from him in a while. This accent is an insult to hillbillies. I mean, you're right. But they're hillbillies, so they probably can't afford internet. Anyways, this suit is my own creation and has a vaginal slit and a working sheath and big furry balls. Let's see. I think this is the head. It appears to evolve over time like some sort of bizarre Pokemon. Notice the lamprey mouth. Well, sadly... Again, because this is an archive, because Sherrod de Hippo fucking went to jail or whatever the fuck happened. I don't even think it's her anymore. I think it's some other person who went the fuck to jail. But whatever happened, Encyclopedia Dramatica is down. And so we're looking at this through an archive. Sadly, we can't see the full version of this picture. Maybe we'll find it in the wild, but yes, it does seem to evolve over time. Franken Fursuit as depicted at Mephit Furmeet 06. Shadow, A sheath and tail hole. Murr, enjoy. Here's her pseudo-pussy. Showing some pubic fur. Oh, whoa. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so time to get into the real bad shit, folks. Hope you're ready for all of this stuff. This is a return to the snake thing business. Furries call those holes SPH. Yet, surgically produced holes are punctured. Strategically placed hole. I can hear the sober in your voice. Yes, I haven't drank yet. So I heard you like... Woof! Grr! Hi there! First, I'm a zoo and love my partners without question. Love large and medium dogs and calves, mini ponies, pygmy goats. I prefer to be on top. Of course, a nice hard shag by a sexy beast is good, too. Can't wait to tie with a nice friendly male chow chow, my fave. Or a Saint Bernard for mutual fun. I'm also a furry and a yiffy furry artist / author, fursuiter, fursuit maker. My fantasy is to have a fursuit fur pile, males and females, and tape me being used like the little horny bitch I am inside. Anyone who thinks it's wrong is to love animals physically is wrong. You know, they bond with us when we become their lovers as well as their masters. And also, there's nothing hotter than a bitch in heat, except maybe a mare in heat, lol. Shadow Wolf asks on how he enjoys fucking animals. I have my own version, which is a non-anthro female Saint Bernard around 3 feet tall sitting. I went to a sex shop and bought a quality latex vagina for her. Total cost $18 and lubed with some KY, it feels better than any woman I ever yiffed. You can even adjust the tightness by adding more fiberfill to the dog. Be sure and get the one with the large nubs inside. It is heaven. Woof! Shadow Wolf S on how he enjoys fucking stuffed animals, too. And this here is apparently his form, his beast forum profile signature. Hey, all you other zoos. I love to screw large willing dogs anally and vaginally. I also love to be knotted by medium-sized dogs, but have taken my Dane Tommy's 8-inch cock up my ass, all except his 4-inch knot. Ouch! If you do and have pics, please PM me or hear my personal email and some defunct old ancient email address. I haven't yet screwed a male husky, but I will as soon as I get one for a pet. They are really into anal sex, my friends assured me. If not, well, he can always knot me. Nice. It's nice. Nice. And then we have this picture again, which we saw on the Flickr. Possible actual dog fucking happening in this photo. We see this dog, as it says, forced to live in filth right here. Again, if we'd like to get a better look at that dog being forced to live in filth, we can see it. Ooh, we're moving something around. Oh, that's the giant picture of Boogie. Hang on. We can see it here. You can see this dog. Just look at this, like, look at this fucking Cooking with Hoarders-esque room that this dog is in. There's all these, like, there's just shit on the floor. This place hasn't been fucking vacuumed in 7 years. There's, like, newspapers happening. There's, the dog just looks like it's in fucking fear for its life, you know? And it fucking, it probably should be. Jesus Christ, okay. The poor pupper. Jazz music stops. Let's see how does this continue. It reminds me of my experience working as a dog walker for our local shelter when I fucked a very receptive 1-year-old male golden in his large pink hot wet anus in the bathroom there with the door locked. I came within seconds of pushing into his hot wet ass. What a beautiful experience for us both, as he came all over the bathroom floor. He really loved my 8-inch cock up his ass. 1-year-old dog, guys. Working as a dog walker. How do you guys feel about that? The guy's a dog walker. Hey, everybody. This is officially a bully stream. We are officially bullying this fucking psychopathic weirdo. Break out your fucking pitchforks. This is officially a goddamn bully stream. That's absolutely fucking disgusting. Okay, now, let me see. What else of this is there worth showing? Well, okay, there's this part here, which I'm not going to show, but I will read parts of it out. There's phone numbers and addresses and things. I'd rather not show that. But there's parts surrounding it which say, Bill is very willing to give out his address and phone number, and as such expects that if you have a dog you don't want anymore, you'll just leave it at his house for some rapings for the rest of its life. His phone number is listed, his address. Beware Craigslist postings in this area seeking dogs. Since Bill has come to the public's attention, he has been rather transient. He has, quote-unquote, lived in many cities, often crashing with unsuspecting furries and molesting their animals. These places include various southern Bible Belt and such places. So, yeah, that is more or less the Encyclopedia Dramatica page for this fellow. This wonderful contributor to humanity. I'm not showing the dogs. You can see the link. If you want to fucking go to the page, you can see the link. But this is officially a bully stream. But, you know, we have a little bit of class, okay? A little bit of class. I'd like a bullet. All right, just give me a bullet. So that's the Encyclopedia Dramatica page. Now, again, as I've said, this guy seems to have really thoroughly scrubbed a lot of his stuff off of the internet. Seemingly a lot better than he scrubbed his fucking fursuit, from what I've heard. And so, a lot of what we have to go by here... This post got deleted by the mods on this subreddit. Because it's just a little too fucked up. But, I mean, the thread is still archived. And I'm pretty sure what this linked to is just this picture once again. It's alarming because this guy is a lot more fucked up than even this fursuit leads one to believe. You look at this and you assume there's some shit going on, but then when you dig a little deeper, you learn exactly 100% unequivocally that there is some shit going on. There is some shit afoot. And so it's exciting to look at people here who, some of whom are just looking at this thing for the first goddamn time, and they're just seeing the fursuit, and they're like, wow, that's frightening. And they don't know that this guy admits to raping 1-year-old puppies. It's like a furry burn victim covered in skin grafts. This is nightmare fuel. I want to see more. I had an encounter with this guy at AnthroCon back in 2008. He actually pursued us away from the downtown convention center and through an alleyway when we tried to disengage from his attention. It took us doubling back to the con center and informing security to get him away from us. A friend of mine also had a run-in with him at the now-defunct OklaCon a couple years ago. The whole kit and caboodle was on display. The terrible BO, the mangled Frankenstein costume, and the uninvited conversation describing how he constructed his suit. There isn't enough gasoline in this world. Your run-in with him in the alley sounds like a friend of mine's encounter, but God, I'm sorry you had to deal with this thing. I can't even imagine the smell. I also had a very weird and creepy encounter with him. He stalked me, trying to constantly get my attention. Also, he smelled strongly of piss and told me Hannibal Lecter was his hero. Oh, and just so you know, he wasn't trolling. He had his fursuit head off this whole time, and he was clearly a disturbed guy. I remember him looking a lot like Steve Buscemi on meth. I think I mentioned that earlier, and you know... Look at this dude. Look at this dude. That's pretty Steve Buscemi on meth, if you ask me. I agree, so... This is real. Dude, I've met that guy at AnthroCon back in 2007. He's just as scary as that suit is. This guy, from what I'm told, made this suit out of torn up stuffed animals that he fucked. He has never washed it, probably never washed himself either, and has even cleared out entire rooms just because of his stench. He is also apparently a zoophile and possibly a pedophile. Well, you know, maybe he only fucks baby dogs and not baby children, you know? Let's stay optimistic here. People like this always confuse me. Do they have no desire to do anything productive in their lives? If I do something little wrong, like eat more than I should, I feel like shit. But this guy fucks stuffed animals and clothes himself in them. Met him at an AC. That's a disturbing resume. Like, really? What the fuck? Sounds like he probably has some mental or personality disorder. So what you're telling me is that he looks scary as shit, smells terrible, has mental issues, constructed a persona and visage to fit, and then goes to cons and scares people. Sounds like the most legit villain to ever set foot in a con, if you ask me. Well, I mean, it's a furry convention. Everybody's a villain, you know, if you believe in yourself. I'd like to know why people always jump to pedophile when describing these fandoms. It seems like furries, brownies, blah blah blah. I have not seen any evidence of him saying that he wants to fuck children, but I mean, why wouldn't I believe it? He apparently fucks baby dogs, so like, why, you know, and what's anything's possible. That rug really ties the room together. Oh, you know, you're right. It puts on the carpet powder, or it gets the hose again. Yeah, this is not the first thing that I've seen compare this guy to fucking like the Buffalo Bill of fursuit people. Is that a yellow ribbon he's wearing? If he won third place for the most terrifying bunny outfit, I wonder what first and second look like. Maybe they gave him that so he'd leave. So this company that mails shit to people on your behalf, I'd love to start a business that does the same thing, but with this guy. Just a business with the sole purpose of mailing shit to this guy. That's cool. So judging from the carpet, that which isn't on him, this was taken at AnthroCon, and from these comments, he's been at more than one. How long did he attend before being banned? At least I pray he has already been. I'm heading this year and would love to run into him. According to everyone in this thread, he's probably already been banned. I've been going for the past few years to meet with friends I don't get to see otherwise. I'm not a furry myself, and I've never seen or smelled this guy. Let's see. Oh, this is a good one. Come on, bro. How are you going to rip on him? He's just trying to make ends meet. He lives with his mom in a two-bedroom apartment. They're both unemployed, living on disability, and his mom's on SI checks. Since they're on a fixed income, they can barely feed themselves. This guy is really committed and finally found something he loves and truly enjoys. There's no way he can buy a brand new shiny fox suit, he knows in the back of his mind, but that won't deter him, no. He loves it and has to get inside the world of virgins in fursuits. He is desperate for any sexual contact whatsoever, be from either gender. He is so physically unattractive, he figures there's no way that this could be possible, so he goes for it. He heads to a low-end carpet store and asks for their finest floor furs. The salesman gladly takes him over to his options and asking him various questions. He lies about everything, his wife, his house he's renovating, everything. Eventually, he convinces the guy to give him samples of every type of Dollar Tree carpets they had. Excited, he heads back to assemble his dream. As he stitched his suit together, he thinks in the back of his mind the action he is about to receive. As he finishes stitching the last piece of material, his pants become tighter, and he begins quivering at the thought of his first convention. His mom yells at him to come out for dinner as he puts his costume away. The day finally comes. As he is unemployed, he has been waiting this entire time, dreaming of this day, trying his costume on time and time again. He grabs his costume and puts it on. Yelling for his mom to hurry up, he runs to their 1992 Toyota Corolla. They finally arrive at the expo, and he sees the rest of the virgins flailing around in their fursuits. He throws his carpeted fur head on and gets out of the car, still nervous about social interaction, but he knows no one can see his acne, so he begins to gain some self-confidence and fraternize with the other fur-loving freaks. Yeah, how dare we say shit about him? Oh shit, Boogie's dead. Oh shit, we've got porn bots, everybody. Are there mods? Mods, ban anybody talking about porn bots. Do your job, mods. Wait, unhide. Fuck off. Get out of here. Get the fuck out of here, porn bots. Why do I gain sympathy for him? Sangi is a vibe right now. End it with Tips Fedora, and then it's a fully Reddit post. I think it's a joke, chat. Yes, it's a joke, don't worry. But how dare we? I agree. He's right. This has really given me some perspective. Five nights at Fuck My Life. Oh, neat. Saw this dude at Zootopia. Yeah, so this is some experiences that people have had with... I don't want to know what that's all about. This is some experiences that some people have had with this guy. Some interesting testimony from certain people. Smelled strongly of piss, apparently. A lot of corroborating stories here. A lot of people having similar experiences with this lad. This was 3 years ago that people were posting about this on Reddit. There's been a few threads about it. There's been some discussion, but again, this is a guy who hasn't been around for a long time. For all we know, he's dead. So, I mean, you know, frankly, good riddance if so, but if not, if you decide to sue me, that would be fucking hilarious. That's fine, though. This is a confirmed bully stream, so I don't really know if there's that much else to look at. He's got a couple of fur affinities and things like that, but there's not really anything. Oh, thank you, Reddit. There's not really anything where it comes to carpet sample boy that I haven't really looked at here. I mean, there's definitely more that I haven't seen, but again, a lot of it seems to have been deleted. So that's pretty unfortunate. What are we doing on porn bots? Rip Joe Rogan. Oh, guys. Is he Shadow Wolf S? Yes, that is one of his many nicknames. Talking about K-pop pisses Claw off. Well, not if it's the female kind. Not if it's the fan cam kind. Lots of furries on Reddit, no surprise. I mean, it is Reddit. Ban anyone who knows what I said. Mrs. Obama, get down. Have you ever covered Tumbles the Stair Dragon? What the fuck is that? I would love to cumble that sometime. Alright, well, that'll probably about do it for the carpet suit. That will probably about do it for the carpet sample fursuit guy. Again, it's just kind of an infinitely spiraling well of snake thing energy. But don't go away, we've got more interesting shit to come. Namely, oh god, where is it? Yes. Oh god, oh no. Okay, chat. Next up, I don't know if we still need the snake thing. I think it, or rather the sangi. I think it might be appropriate to remove the sangi. But it is still some weird sex weirdo business, so I don't know. It's up to you guys, frankly. We're going to be looking at female masking. Which, as you can see, means masks of women that look very realistic, I promise. Keep the sangi. The sangi stays on. Well, the chat has spoken. Here's an amazing female mask. This one's 20 seconds. Oh, look, it's amazing, guys. That is so realistic. Can't you imagine seeing that in a dark alley? He's like tugging on the neck skin. That's not disturbing in any way. The thing that I definitely feel when I look at this is cute. That's just so cute. Here's one. Mask disguise in the night. Oh no, is this person going out with... Oh no. Oh no. Boy, that's quite something. That is quite, oh yeah, hike that up, girl. You are sexy and you know it. What about this one? Oh god, oh my god, the fucking androids are taking over, chat. I feel fantastic. I mean, okay. At least it's at night, you know? Like, if you see this wonderful face. Can you imagine you're like a person with mental problems or whatever, and you're walking down the street one night and you've got like paranoia happening? And you look and you see somebody coming in your direction, and they look like a fucking living doll Auton creature from Doctor Who. That would be a little fucked up. Okay. Let's see here. What else do we got? Cross-dress with female mask. Taylor female mask. Oh, I do love getting copyright claimed. Thank you. I mean, I guess I'm already getting claimed for the song that I opened the thing with, but look at that totally realistic mask, guys. You love how there's like gaps on the eyes. There's like, you can see the seams. Yeah. Imagine the smell underneath the mask, everybody. Imagine that one. Oh, this one's got like some Bayonetta vibes happening. What's going on here? Trans Pog, huh?
What's up, guys? So this is a cheap mask I got.
Okay, I'm not. This is shifted away from Bully Stream to some extent. Let's just say that whatever you gotta do, you gotta do. But if you're wearing If you are actually wearing this, I'm sorry. You have earned your spot on my channel.
On AliExpress, it's like Amazon, but it's based in China. And I got this on sale for a little under $100.
Oh, you can tell.
Okay, this mask is called Emily.
Wow, Jesus Christ! Look at this, guys. Look at what we are observing currently. This is. Look at how they're tugging on the skin and like the eyes. It's like it's fucking dead.
And I don't know who the manufacturer is because there's multiple people selling the mask. You can see here, like it's kind of short,
God.
So that's why I have the collar up to the neckline. Unfortunately, my skin's pretty pale.
Oh God! So no, put the hair back on.
But, I don't know. I underestimated how pale my skin is.
You kind of also underestimated where your eyes are. Jesus Christ. Jesus fucking Christ. Every frame a cursed image. You guys know every frame of painting? This is every frame a cursed image. What the fuck is this? Oh God, it's like close-ups. Look at it, it's suffering. It's like a re-dead from Zelda. This feels like a choking hazard. This feels like something that would kill a person. I don't like this. They take off the mask. And then, oh, what is this?
Update video. Oh. That I uploaded last week. Which I was going to do first, but there's a bunch of new mask channels coming up, and I thought...
Oh, we got some junk in the trunk here, everybody. All right, well, that's fine. That's good. Oh, my, what is this creature? You know, it's appropriate, because the last guy was the carpet sample fursuit guy, and now this is like getting back to a little more toward Buffalo Bill territory. It's right in the same, like, wheelhouse. What do you think, guys? Don't you guys agree that this is beauty in its purest form? Hey, hey, hey! Yeah, I would say stick to In the Night. By the way, hey guys, it's Spoonie's ex-girlfriend Scarlett, everybody. Thank you, Noble. Very cool.
Alright, that's quite enough of that. I like the ominous silence of the video. It's wonderful. Got some more walking around at night. Female masking outside. This one's got 10,000 views. Okay, again, from like a distance, I guess you might be able to fool people, but... Oh no, don't smile. Please don't smile. To be fair, I guess there are people who just look like this. This one is better than the other one, yes, but not enough. Not enough better. It's just this ominous silence. They don't say anything. Oh God, what the fuck is this? Female mask disguise. Guys, what's happening? Why are we still here? just to suffer? Every night, I feel my mask. What do you think, guys? You think this is like a scene out of a fucking horror movie, but actually for real and not a joke? Because that's what I'm getting from this. This is a good channel. 21 subs. What else we got? Female mask 2 hours ago. Oh, we got a lot of video. There is a lot of content here, everybody. This is exciting. No panties in public. That's too hot for YouTube right there. No panties public. Upskirt, pantyhose, panty. Let's do this one from 2 hours ago. Now, this one's got production values, you know? Like, this channel has... really has it going on. The other ones, they were just walking around, but this one, there's like... this is like a Bat for Lashes album cover. This is like crazy shit. If I took that mask off, would you die? Oh, sexy. Fierce and fabulous right there. There's definitely bodies in that house. Please tell me this ends in a house fire. Possibly. Why are there like two tiny little doll children? For that matter, why are there mannequins? This is actually cursed content. She do be feeling fantastic though. Stop, I've gone too deep. Those aren't mannequins. Yeah, wasn't there a guy on Fringe who killed people and turned them into dolls? Not making any accusations. I'm just remembering one of my favorite shows. What else do we have here? Ladyboy, panty tights. I'd like to point out again that this has nothing to do with shaming, like, trans people or anything. If you're stupid enough to... like, think that, then I can't really help you, but, you know, I would like to point that out. This is just a whole other thing. The transness of it is secondary. This isn't even really, it's transvestite. I think that's like a cross-dresser. What could upskirt panty, how is this on YouTube? Hang on. Let me just fucking see this one for my own damn self. Alright, this one's age restricted, not surprisingly, so I'm not going to be able to see that one. Apparently YouTube is aware of it enough to age restrict it, but not enough to not have it, like, exist on the platform. Let's go back to the original video on this channel, Female Possession. Strongest knees in the game. This time the music's actually in the video. To be fair, this is kind of artistic. I mean, yeah, it is artistic at the very least. It's got some fucking weird, interesting quality to it. Female, there's another female possession. Actually, there's a few of these. All right, what's this one? Female transformation. I'm sure it'll be very different from the other ones. Uh-oh, this is lewd. Uh-huh. Oh, did we just see the face? Oh, that's the actual dude, okay. And here's the realistic face. It's cool. Good to see the panties and everything. I don't know about you guys, but I am hard as fuck right now. I am solid chub. So, okay. That's this fucking channel. Thank you. That's enough of that. Let's take a look at a little bit more. Dominatrix with a twist. Oh, don't age restrict your shit, you pussies. Oh, look, female masking pony. This is fine, chat. This is totally fine. No part of this is cursed. Hello. Domo. I'm experiencing what you might call a solid snake thing. The absence of any sound is really making this special. Mm-hmm. I'm glad that we got this fully unedited. I'm also glad that the hair underneath the pony helmet. Well, look at how they're struggling to put it on. The hair underneath the pony helmet is the same as the hair on top. Hans get everything. Aiden Paladin's just talking in moon runes. God damn it, Aiden, I don't know that much kanji yet. Alright. So this is the My Little Pony. What else do we have on this? Oh, this one's got 737 subscribers. What else is going on here? I like how this channel went from, like, video games to... Okay, never mind. This was always a weird fucking channel. What else is on here? Furry Follow Me Eyes. Kigurumi Felis Noir Unboxing. Oh god. Well, this one's got some sound. What am I looking at? What the fuck am I looking at? Oh, it's so cute, everybody. As with many things on this channel, this is one of those litmus test things where it's like, if you look at this and you find yourself thinking, this is adorable, something's probably fucked with you. Something's probably fucked in your head. If you look at this and you go, Jesus Christ, get the fucking Flammenwerfer, then I think that's maybe the appropriate response. I don't know. Not a bully stream. Don't tell me they're not harming anybody. Are you watching the stream? See, now there's, like, sound, and you can hear him shifting around a little bit. But you can't... There's no sound, though. He doesn't talk. He doesn't giggle. He doesn't make any, like, noises. No. How many cats was this suit made of? This isn't the carpet sample guy, so... I mean... This is probably made of fewer dead cats. I don't know how the Chinese make their fursuits, but... Oh, it's just so cute. Does he start talking? No.
He's got a fucking bell. Alright, that's enough of that. Thank you. Oh god, wait. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? Oh, thank you, Japan. Alright. Thank you, Japan. Thank you. Very cool. That's enough of this channel. Thank you. I'll do like one more in this category. Close up of a female mask. We're looking for one that's exceptionally good. Like really high quality content. Like this one. Oh yes. Oh yes. I'm sure they're very excited to have you.
And next we're going to go to Walmart, and after that, we're probably going to call it a day.
Why are they so shiny?
Fantastic Sunday. I know I am. The outside is very cool outside.
Looks like it's Karen.
And I hope to...
I keep seeing you bitches in the chat telling me you're tapping out and you're done. Man, we got through the dude who fucks one-year-old puppies. And now you're tapping out? Okay, guy.
And then that's Walmart, and then...
Alright, get to it. Get to the errands. Oh, look at the folds. It's got more like pores on its face than Kuze from Yakuza 0. It's quite remarkable. Yeah, it does look like white chicks. This looks exactly like white chicks. Bizarro World Emberlin. Yeah, it's trans Peter Griffin. I like that one. Again, we've got like just the soft rustling of things happening. Actual people saw this in person. Yes, this is out and about in public. This is at a flea market. Imagine you're doing your job and you see this face. Why is the default expression trying not to fart in the grocery aisle? You're right. Or just like mild Karen annoyance. The double lips just look fantastic. You imagine trying to bargain with this person, barter, you're doing deals, you see two sets of lips moving independently. Farting in there might kill him. When you set the character creation to random. Man, this is what it means to be truly American. You think you'd see this shit in, like, Kuwait? No, motherfucker. You ain't seeing female masking in the country of Omar. Oh, look at the pores. Have you heard of the high elves? Yeah, it kind of does. It does look a bit like a... Wait, that's just the first store. Oh, there's multiple stores, I forgot. We're gonna get to see other people, guys. Keep your eyes out for like people reacting. It's so intensely sad. You're watching this person go out and they're just trying to do... This person is just trying to do the daily errands, you know, but here you have, like, darting eyes left and right, making sure nobody's looking at, you know, this horrendous, disgusting fucking mask. Like, this is just no way to live. God. Ugh. I'm a pretty girl, right? I am, right? Now again, chat, we're not doing this out of hatred for any communities or anything, but I mean, come on, look at this. You mean to tell me we're not all thinking the same thing? Good God, alright. Gonna buy some, like, more quilts and fabrics and things, make a nice carpet sample fursuit. I got you.
And didn't get to the park, but I had a good time. And
nice.
It's just one of those days where you just, it's going to be a really, really, really good Sunday. And I hope everybody has a great Sunday and a great...
Oh, I'm having a fantastic Tuesday. Thank you. Right, so this is Divine Du Jour, everybody. And, oh... My, okay, there's a lot of masks here. Oh, guys.
Good evening, everybody.
Oh, guys, it's like Eddie Murphy in that movie. Okay, well, that's fine. That's fine. I think that's about it for the female masking community. Very interesting stuff. Technically, they're not really doing anything wrong. But it's definitely difficult to look at any of these videos and not immediately think, once again, about Buffalo Bill. And getting the hose again. So that's enough of that. Yeah, let's see. Do we want to do something else? I think I might cut the stream a little short, honestly. I feel like both of these segments could make decent videos on their own. So, yeah. Maybe I will kind of wrap it here. This has been a bit of a short stream. I might go again later, potentially. It might be time for, like, a drunk gaming stream. Maybe I'll do drunk bully or drunk Yakuza, finally. That could be fun. But, you know, no promises. We might not do a second one today. But, yeah, we're going a little shorter, I think, with this one. I'm going to read off some Super Chats. Again, I'm having problems with seeing the Super Chats because fucking Streamlabs OBS is not... It's not doing its job, so that's pretty annoying. But we're gonna look at some things here. Let's see. $5 from Bill Dill. I have the flu and have been puking for the past 2 days, but your live stream is just what the doctor ordered. Thank you, Claw Senpai. Oh, well, I hope you feel better. Try to keep it away from the coronavirus, you know, and you should be good. $5 from Nero Altis. I know this is off topic. When you can, look up DC Douglas. He's the creepiest guy in voice acting. If you want info on him, ask Lord Schmecky. Okay, DC Douglas. Hello, Douglas. Oh, he looks like a creepy sex weirdo. Okay. That's interesting. That's interesting. I will keep that. And we'll keep that saved. Thank you for the suggestion. $2 from Durs. I'm a furry. Proud of you. Well, I hope you enjoyed the stream. 40 rubles from FU Susan. His fursona should be Coomer the dog. Speaking of Coomer the dog, we might want to look into this Boomer the dog fellow, this furry who is apparently friends with the carpet sample guy and evidently was on Dr. Phil, so that's pretty interesting. Maybe another time that could be worth looking at. Mr. Skeleton Pants with $2. Anyone quelling yet? I don't know what quelling is, but I know I'm feeling quelly. $5 from Moop. Long hair guy in that one photo is Boomer the dog, who's really weird, but overall pretty harmless. Not the creepy guy we're covering today, though. I don't know which long hair guy you're talking about, but I guess one of the pictures we looked at, maybe. was someone else. Maybe they look kind of similar, but yeah. Let's see, $2 from Just Vibin'. I'm uncomfortable sharing a planet with this man. You know, it'd be like that sometimes. You watch a stream, you experience existential dread on account of the things that you've witnessed. It's just, you know, it's just a typical Tuesday. $2 from Kate Rao Rao. This isn't just a snake thing. This is a serpent noun. Ooh, this is the advanced like Ivysaur of snake things. This is the Charizard of snake things. $5 from Baltazar Bruno. Oh whoa, Clawfather just joined the stream. Are we looking at epic Kringe today? I guess so. I think it was pretty Kringe. I thought we were going to talk about more stuff, but I mean, you know, I think sometimes it's worth it to keep streams a little shorter, a little sweeter. But I think we found some good Kringe. $2 from Moop once again. Okay, I take it back. I've lost all respect for Boomer. Yeah, that's the thing is I don't know how innocent you can be if you're friends with somebody who admits to wanting to fuck dogs in the ass. Who admits to having fucked dogs in the ass. Neon Lemmy Koopa with $2. At long last, tonight, my sickos, we bully! This was the designated bully stream, at least the first half of it, anyway. $2 from Dis Dan Dan. That fursuit is absolutely horrifying. Holy shit! Yes, it's quite the nightmare. Quite the absolute nightmare. 100 rubles from Steve Redka. My name is DeadwingDork, and I like Despicable Me more than Megamind. Well, actually, my name is DeadwingDork, and I haven't watched the... The last animated movie I watched was Spider-Verse, and the last one I watched before that was probably, like, The Incredibles 1. So, I don't think that company's produced anything of fucking value. Isn't Despicable Me the Minions company? Isn't that what that is? Yeah, I think that's fine. $5 from ZZZZZZ. This guy ate the end of lead pipe when he tried to touch my dog. Oh, what? You know this feller? This hard R feller? This guy ate the end of a lead pipe when he tried to touch my dog. Fellow furries, keep ousting pedos and zoos. Purge them from our hobby. Do not cease. Actually, I have one final thing to show you before we finish the stream. One last thing that I forgot to mention before, because that was very interesting. One last thing, which was shown on one of the pages linked on the ED page. I forget which one. Is it the Wiki Fur? Is this the one? I think it might be the Wiki Fur, which I would rather not... That's a website I'd rather not click on, but... Yes, this is the Wiki Fur, and I'm going to read one thing for you here. Down here at the bottom, controversy. He was banned from Memfit Fur Meat, or Mefit Fur Meat, for proposing the sexual use of a fellow fur, Moonstone Winds, handicap assistance dog, while in a secluded elevator with her. He has been known to make extremely inappropriate sexual comments to both furs and non-furs in public. He often ghosts conventions sleeping in the lobby instead of paying for a room. So yes, he got like banned from a convention because he proposed the use of of someone's handicap assistance dog for the fucking. You know, world-class stuff right there. World class stuff. Just the finest human beings. Okay, let's see. $5 from Mint Solstice. How about some Magnus fursuits? Acid Horse, Acid Wolf. He was banned from Anthrocon recently. I don't know who any of those people are, but that's interesting to hear. Acid Horse, Acid Wolf. Might look into that. $5 from Albino Axolotl. Goop stream when? There's not that much to say about Goop, but I don't know. Maybe at some point it could be interesting. There's not much to say about Goop that hasn't already been said. Enough of it isn't that interesting for, like, at least covering in a stream. In a video, it might be okay, but there's already a lot of videos about Goop. I don't know. I think about it, though. I think about it. $2 from Space Corps. Hey, Claw, have you been to Buffalo, New York? Also, what the fuck? Well, I used to live slightly north of Buffalo, New York. That was nice. Niagara Falls area. But I've never been to Buffalo, no. 200 yen from Absolute Madman. These masks are like in that Daft Punk movie. Something like that. $2 from Josh Shrum. Where is Squall, Deadwing Dork? Squall is dead. Haven't you heard? $2 from Snotbrains. Tonetta, Stinky Toronto, forever. Tran. 40 rubles from Medicare's Lunacorn Archives. I want off Mr. Leatherface's Wild Ride. Well, thankfully I cut that shit short once we got to the Eddie Murphy face masks. €2 from, you're gonna say this fucking name wrong. Giedra Machulata, I'm sorry. I can't say that. I only wanted to draw, now I want to die. Frowny face. And then I also fucked up saying your name, so I'm sorry. $2 from the first Dalek. Oh, we got Davros in chat, everybody. Claw, what the fook have you unearthed? Well, it's not so much what I've unearthed. People have known about this guy for quite some time. I'm just going to be the one to make a video about him. As long as that fucker Wang doesn't beat me to the punch. No, I'm just kidding. Although he did actually, he did make a video about the maggot girl, just the blowfly girl, just before I did my Patreon video about that. So that was a thing that happened. So I better get this fucking video made before Wavy Web Surf beats me or something. $5 from Stephen Lofton. This snake thing made me want to vomit, but these skinwalkers disturb me on a deeper level. I mean, this guy was, oh, I guess you're talking about the skin, yeah, the female mask people. That's definitely, yeah, I don't know about that one. That's definitely pretty disturbing. I can agree with that. $5 from Reese's Pieces. Imagine wearing two masks to hide your masculinity. I mean, they don't call it masculinity for nothing. $2 from Mr. Curie. 11728 reminds me of white chicks, LMFAO. Lettuce, mayonnaise, fingers, and onions. Yeah, it's very white chicks-esque, I can agree. Wannerty 2 with $2. Looks like a burn victim. Mm-hmm. Definitely. $2 from my lady class. What would you do if you were a police officer? Donuts. I would eat donuts, because I hear that that's encouraged and expected. So that's what I would do. $5 from Dis Dan Dan. The chubby Karen dude reminds me of that one video of a guy literally ejaculating onto a Rainbow Dash figurine. Does anyone even remember that video? I think I may have seen it at some point in the past 10 years, but there's probably multiple videos of that, so sorry to shatter your worldview, but there's a lot of people jizzing on their ponies right now. $5 from Adorable Cockroach. Look up Margaret ASMR. It's worse than any of these. Margaret ASMR. Ooh, and we're saving that one for a future stream. Thank you for the suggestion. £5 from Jay Dethier Lowe. I just turned up and I met with a bargain bucket Bratz doll looking feller. What the hell did I miss? Nothing of too much importance. Just some weird, insane, fucked up garbage. Let me see. £2 from John Smith. You need to do the few crew at some point. Well, what do we got here? A new suggestion has entered the chat. The few crew. Oh boy, I like this just by looking at it. Thank you for the suggestion. I'll save that one. $2 from Milady Class. Mr. Skeleton Pants is my brother. Huh. I'm your brother! I'm your brother! $5 from Magos Damaris. Left work early because I didn't feel well. Watched your stream. Feel worse. Good job. Well, welcome back home, Skelly. I hope you I hope you feel a little better for the rest of the day. Try eating some gamer fuel. Get some Dorit to yeet your meat. Oh, that should help you. And finally, we've got $5 from my lady class. I have friends that are furries. None of them are as degenerate as some of the people you've covered. If anything, they all hate people like that. I mean, I keep hearing about these furries that aren't into this shit, and yet all of them still have... All of these people, like Cepheus, still has a fucking fur affinity. So I don't know. It seems like there needs to be some kind of a line in the sand somewhere where people just say, no, this is not right. This does not stand up to the light. I don't know. I feel like if you're not going to be a sex weirdo, you should... Oh, God, the fucking... Speaking of sex weirdos, the sex bots are back. God damn it. Got lost, you fuckers. Who the fuck keeps attacking me with sex bots? I know it doesn't happen on its own. I know some fucking weirdo is trying to, like... Inject the sex bots directly into my cock vein. So, that's pretty annoying. I don't know. Anyways, I think that'll about do it for the stream. A little bit of a shorter one than usual. We covered a couple things. This one, again, won't be archived. You will be able to find it on the stream's playlist, if I remember to put it there. But I think probably both of these segments will make pretty good videos. So I'm gonna be putting... You're probably going to see the carpet sample guy. That video might be edited down within the week, even, because I do kind of want to take a closer look at that. Maybe I'll get some more info after the stream goes up. Maybe some people might be able to reach out with some more pictures and stuff that I might be able to show in the edit. We'll see. But yeah, that'll about do it once again. Thank you, everybody, for stopping by. Thank you for not fucking your dogs in the ass. And if you do, please unsubscribe. Well, I mean, I don't know if you need to unsubscribe. Don't watch my videos anymore, but stay subscribed because, you know, I need the numbers. But anyways, take care, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys next time. Penis.